Hi, and today we're looking at the gas exchange features of a leaf, which means that we have to, of course, look at stomata and their guard cells. Now, there are several ways of viewing it, and if you're at A-level and you're doing this experiment, what we want is an evaluation of which method is the best, limitations of a method, and explanation around that. This is a fabulous plant to use. It's called Tradescantia, and why it's so good is because the leaves are green on the top, and purple on the bottom. If I remove one of these, when I look at the underside, which is of course where we find the stomata, what we find is that against a purple background, the guard cells appear green. And because of that, they're really easy to identify. So no specialist techniques are needed. We can literally just put that on the microscope. You might want to clamp it down. Remember, you don't want a three-dimensional image. You want it as flat as possible, and of course wind it all the way up, look through your microscope and wind it away. Best if we start on the lowest magnification, winding it all the way up and having a look. Wow, what an image I've got there, beautiful. Now I'm going to take a photograph of that with my phone, very easy to do. Takes a little bit, keep your elbows in. Stops the wobble. Lovely. I'm now going to move it on to a higher magnification. So I'll wind it away, change the lens, wind it up, and have a little look there. Oh, even nicer. You know those stomata have come into really clear focus. Wow. Okay. Take another photo. I'm going to try the highest focus, which is, of course, times 400. I'm going to roll it all the way up. Rolling it away using the coarse focus. I've just got one lovely one in the middle there and one at the top. Let me see if I can get a photograph of that. Lovely. Now the other way that we can do this is by taking an imprint of the leaf using some nail varnish. Now I've tried lots of different leaves. And this type of plant, I think it's something called a ficus, I'm not quite sure, but it'll be common to you, you'll have seen it's a house plant. These leaves produced the best results. So take a leaf, in fact you don't even need to take it off really, could have saved that. Make sure it's dust free. Some clear nail polish, this is like really cheap stuff. Stinks. Do a little imprint there. Take a clean slide, it's clean enough. I want to let that dry for a minute. Okay, we're going to use some sellotape, making sure we don't put our fingerprints all over the bit. And what we do then is place it on top of the leaf, smooth it over. And then peel it off, get a lovely imprint, and that can just stick straight down onto the microscope slide, like so. Again, starting on our lowest magnification, pop it in there, wind it up, look through it, wind it away. Now at this point you might need to reposition it a little bit.